discussed the discrete time Fourier series representation, and this is DTFS. DTFS is basically representation of a discrete time periodic signal in the Fourier domain, right? And we discussed that x of n can be expressed as it's a summation of k equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k e to the power j omega 0 n k. Omega 0 is the fundamental frequency, which is defined by 2 pi by n, okay? And x of k is nothing but the Fourier coefficients, which represents this x of t in the frequency domain, x of k. And x of k is, again, we term this as inverse Fourier representation. Sorry, this is the Fourier Fourier representation. This is x of k, capital X of k, right? And k is nothing but the frequency components. And x of k equal to 1 upon n, summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of n e to the power minus j k omega 0 n, right? So then you can go from x of n to x of k. And then again, we can also go back from x of k to x of n, right? So this is called here inverse Fourier representation, inverse Fourier series, and this is the forward is the Fourier series, right? And here x of n is a discrete and periodic in nature, okay? If it is a periodic signal, then its Fourier representation, as we discussed, it is nothing but we call it the Fourier series, right? So, and we discussed one example, taking this one x of n, which is a periodic signal, is of course, is a discrete time, okay? So here, the time index is n, so it is a discrete time signal, and it's periodic of period 5, okay? So after 5, it is getting repeated, okay? After time instant 5, so it is getting repeated, so that's why it's periodic of period 5, right? Then we found out its Fourier representation, the Fourier series representation, that is x of k. And we solved and we found this is the solution of the Fourier representation x of k. And this x of k can be also represented with a magnitude response, okay, which is called the Fourier spectrum. And the phase is called the phase spectrum, okay, Fourier spectrum and phase spectrum. And the magnitude one is called is the spectrum, which is nothing but the amplitude of each frequency component k, right? So phase also, how each frequency component, what is the amount of phase it is having? So that is the distribution is called your phase spectrum. Okay. So this one we discussed last class. Today we'll discuss the signal which is continuous time but periodic in nature. Okay, so since this is a periodic signal, so again the Fourier representation will be Fourier series. Okay, and it is continuous time. So today we'll discuss continuous time periodic continuous time Fourier series. Fourier series, and here the signal is nothing but will be continuous time and periodic, right? So we call it CTFS, continuous time Fourier series representation. If the signal of nature continuous time and periodic, so it will be represented in the Fourier domain as a Fourier series. Okay, so the Fourier series of a signal x of t, which is continuous and periodic with fundamental period t, okay, and then the fundamental frequency is omega by 2 pi, and suppose the fundamental period the signal is t, and then the fundamental frequency of the signal is then it will be omega naught, it will be 2 pi by t. Okay, so again the CTFS, the Fourier series of this signal, can be represented as x of t. Okay, this is continuous in nature, so x of t. So rather than X or P, so I'll put X cap T.
Sorry.
So X cap T will be nothing but summation K equal to minus infinity to infinity X of K e to the power j k omega 0 t, right? Okay, so this is the Fourier series representation of this continuous time periodic signal, and where x of k, which is nothing but the Fourier coefficient for the Fourier series of the signal x of t, is written by 1 upon t 0 to t x of t e to the power minus j k omega 0 t, right? And dt. Okay, so here we are trying to approximate the signal x of t with the help of infinity number of complex exponential of e to the power j k omega 0 t. Okay, so k omega 0 is nothing but it is the harmonics of the fundamental frequency omega 0. And if you multiply with this Fourier coefficients with each of this exponential sinusoids, and then summation of all the sinusoids from k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, so that gives me the approximation of the input signal x of t, right? And this x of k, which is like the Fourier series representation, that will be 1 upon t 0 to t x of t e to the power minus j k omega 0 t. So now I can write here also, so x of t, again this is bidirectional transformation, so from x of t, so we are doing Fourier series, we are getting x of k again, and again we are going back from x of k to x of t, right? Okay, so this is called your continuous time Fourier series representation, and the important factor is here the signal that is to be analyzed, it is should be continuous time and periodic in nature. Okay, if it is a periodic signal, then it will be Fourier series representation. All right, so now let us solve one example so that your understanding will be more clear. So again, let us the signal is of this kind. So you have to find out the signal, the Fourier series representation of the signal given as like this. So it is x of t, and this is your periodic exponential signal. Okay, so it is a decaying exponential signal, kind of like this. Okay, and it go on continuously like this. So this is t, and look at here. So looks like this. Okay, so it looks like a periodic signal of suppose this is 2, 4, 6. Okay, -2, -4. Continue like this. So it is a this x of t is nothing but it is a continuous time periodic signal, and here period is, and you see it is 2. Okay, so from 0 to t, 0 to 2, whatever the signal is there, so it is again getting repeated from 2 to 4, then 4 to 6, like that only. And the negative sign also, it is coming from -2 to 0, then -4 to -2. So that means the time period of the signal is nothing but it is 2. Okay, so this is the time period. So then let us look at how we represent the Fourier series of this x of t. Okay, so now this is time period 2, so it is fundamental frequency will be omega 0 is nothing but 2 pi by t, so it will be 2 pi by 2, so it is nothing but pi. Okay, so the fundamental period of the signal is nothing but what is the pi. Okay, so then we can define this x of t is nothing but, if you look at this x of t is nothing but e to the power minus 2t. Okay, so suppose this one is 2. Okay, Yeah, so in so x of t is e to the power minus 2t, and it is periodic in the interval of then if you define 0 to t to 2. Okay, so I can represent x of t in this manner. So after this, it is again getting repeated the same function. Okay, so with the interval of 2 also, right? Okay, so now if this is my input signal, so I can represent the Fourier series as x of k. So x of k will be nothing but I can write this one as 1 upon t. So 1 upon x of k, if you return, you see this is nothing but 1 upon t 0 to t x of t e to the power minus j k omega 0 t dt, right? So now I will write 1 upon t, so t is 2, time period is 2, so I can write 1 upon 2. So then integration over 1 period, so that is 0 to 2, e to the power minus 2 t, e to the power minus j k, omega 0 t, so omega 0 is nothing but pi, so I can write pi t dt, okay? So this is the Fourier series representation. So now if I will solve this one, 0 to 2, okay, so I can write this one as e to the power minus 2 plus j k pi t dt, okay. So now x of k can be written as 1 upon 2, so this will be nothing but minus of 2 plus j k pi then e to the power minus 2 plus j k pi 0 to 2. Okay. So now if you solve this one, so I can put here 2 instead of k, if I put here 2 over here, so suppose this is t. So if I put here 2 and then 0, the lower limit and upper limit, so I can solve this one like this. So 1 upon 4 plus j k 2 pi, so this one. And I can write 1 minus, so if you put 0 over here, so e to the power minus 0, so that will be 1. So 1 minus minus 4 minus 2 j k pi. Okay, so this is the thing, and this will be the thing. What if you put this equation e to the power minus 4 into e to the power minus j k 2 pi, so e to the power minus j k 2 pi will be nothing but value will be 1 because its magnitude is always 1. So if I solve this one, so I'll get 1 minus in the numerator side, so it will be 1 minus e to the power minus 4 and in the denominator 4 plus j k 2 pi, right? Okay. So this is nothing but called the Fourier spectra, right? So if you look at this Fourier spectra, so if you put go on putting k equal to 1, so you'll get the value of the frequency 1, x of 1. So if you put k equal to 2, so you'll get a frequency of 2, right? So if you look at the magnitude spectrum, it will be nothing but it looks like this. So it will be x of mod of x of k. So mod of x of k will be nothing but this value will be like this. Some higher value, so it is 1 upon 4. And then it starts going decreasing because it is exponential function, e to the power minus 4 is there. So it will be nothing but like this. Right? So it go on decreasing like this. So this is k, and this side also is go on decreasing. So it is a symmetric one. Right? So this is nothing but called your Fourier series spectra, or the spectrum of the Fourier series of this signal x of t. Similarly, we can plot the magnitude spectrum of this the amplitude, this is the magnitude spectrum, the phase spectrum you can plot it taking the magnitude, the phase angle of x of k. Okay, so you can put the phase angle of x of k. So you can see this is will be again the phase spectrum, nothing but it is anti-symmetric spectrum. Okay, this will be like this. So it will be on increasing. Like this. Okay, and this side it is the same value. Want it to be positive, so it will go on increasing like this. Okay, so this is nothing but of angle of x of k. So this is called your phase spectrum, and this is called your magnitude spectrum. Okay, so how do you get the phase spectrum? So angle theta is nothing but tan inverse imaginary component by magnitude component. Okay, is it clear? We get to know how to find out the Fourier series representation of a continuous time periodic signal. Is it clear? Okay. So there is no doubt. So let us go to another representation of the signal. So we call now this is a Fourier transform. Okay, so Fourier transform is nothing, what is the Fourier representation of the aperiodic signal. Okay, so when the period of a signal is tends to infinity, then we call it the aperiodic signal. And there the spectrum k in the magnitude frequency domain, the k the spacing between successive k would be nothing but zero, and we say the spectrum is continuous in nature. Okay, so that's why the aperiodic signal, the Fourier representation is a Fourier transform, and it is continuous in nature. So now let us look at the discrete time non periodic signal. Okay, so that means if it is a discrete time non-periodic signal. Okay, so and here then we are trying to represent the Fourier representation, which is called your discrete time Fourier transform. Okay. Right. So since the signal is non-periodic, so we say a non-periodic signal is period whenever its period is infinity. Okay. So if its period is infinity in the frequency domain, we say the frequency is continuous in nature. So there is no the space between two frequency components in the Fourier representation is zero, and we say it is continuous in nature. So we get a continuous spectra in the Fourier representation. And that type of representation called is the Fourier transform, FT. So it is called DTFT. This is very, very important concept, very, very important theory. So you can utilize this DTFT in the discrete time signals. Okay. And in the higher semesters, we'll be using this DTFT in a very, very useful manner. Okay. So now let us look at elementary wise what is the discrete time non-periodic signal and how we represent its Fourier transform. Okay, so remember here the non-periodic signal is the Fourier representation we call is the Fourier transform. Okay, for periodic signal the Fourier representation we call is the Fourier series. In the Fourier series representation, the spectra or the frequency domain are discrete in nature. But here in non-periodic signal, the spectra or the Fourier representation is continuous in nature, right? Okay. So then the discrete time Fourier transform of a non-periodic signal can be represented as a superposition of complex sinusoids. Okay. hence it involves a continuum frequency in the interval minus pi to pi, right? So the DTFT, of a non-periodic discrete time non-periodic signal, x of a can be computed as this would be nothing but x of a. Okay, so this is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi minus pi to pi and x of e to the power j omega e to the power this j omega a d omega. Okay, so since this is a discrete time non-periodic signal, so here the period is infinity, but in case of discrete time, so we can represent the period is restricted from minus pi to pi. Okay, so that's why the integration is taken over minus pi to pi x of e to the power j omega to the power j omega n d omega. Okay, so it is the notation x of e to the power j omega, or you can write x of omega itself, not issue. So this is the Fourier coefficients associated with the complex sinusoids. Okay, so these are the complex sinusoids e to the power j omega n, right? So then this Fourier coefficients is nothing but represented as e to the power j omega, and some book you find they simply write x of omega. Okay, so these are the frequency levels. So now here omega is continuous in nature, so I'm not putting k over here. So k was for only the periodic signals. Okay, so x of omega can be written as summation. It will be n equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n e to the power minus j omega n dn. So this will be nothing but this one. So this is the x of j, x of omega. It is nothing but summation of complex sinusoids e to the power minus j omega n multiplied with the equivalent coefficients of x of n, and that is getting added from minus infinity to infinity. Okay. So again, this is a bidirectional signal, bidirectional transformation. So that means here we can go from x of a discrete time non-periodic signal to x of omega. Okay. So again, we are coming back from x of omega to x of a. So it is a bidirectional transformation. And remember, x of omega also again it is periodic with it is a periodic spectra, okay? Periodic spectra with period 2 pi. Okay, period 2 pi, because in the discrete time signal, so it can go up to the period is minus pi to pi, okay, or from 0 to 2 pi. So that's why it is a periodic signal, the spectrum will be periodic in nature, with period 2 pi. This is very, very important. Okay, so the spectra of discrete time non-periodic signal are continuous in nature. Okay, so this is continuous and periodic, the spectra of period 2 pi. Okay, so this is the discrete time non-periodic signal. Now let us do one example of DTFT of a discrete time non-periodic signal. So for example, if I take a discrete time non-periodic signal is defined as the signal is x of n, this is alpha to the power n u of n. Okay, so alpha to the power n u n, so it is a non-periodic signal. Okay, So it is not, there is no period for this signal, and it is discrete time because U of n is written. So n is here, so it is a discrete time signal. Now if I write its Fourier transform, okay, DTFT. So its Fourier transform is nothing but x of omega, or we can write it to the power j omega, the same. So it is nothing but summation n equal to minus infinity to infinity alpha to the power n un to the power minus j omega n. Okay. And un is only, this is the unit step function, right? Unit step function is only defined when n greater than 0. Okay. So that's why its summation goes from 0 to infinity. Okay. So I can write this as alpha to the power a to the power minus j omega a, right? Okay. So now, so I can write this as also summation n equal to 0 to infinity. So alpha e to the power minus j omega to the power n, right? Okay. So now this series, this is just like a GP series. So it looks like n summation n equal to 0 to infinity a to the power n. Okay. So if you look at this as a, okay, so it is looks like summation n equal to 0 to infinity a to the power n. So again, it is a GP series, the power series, and it has to converse. Okay. And if diverse, then it is of no use. Okay. So this summation of this function will converge if mod of alpha is greater than equal to 1. Okay. So if mod of alpha greater than 1, so this series diverges. Okay. So if alpha greater than 1, so this alpha to the power n, it will go on diverging, so it will not converge. But when mod of alpha less than 1, so it will converge. Okay. So that means the Fourier transform of this signal will only exist when alpha is less than 1. Now if I put for this condition, when alpha is less than 1, so now my x of omega is nothing but summation n equal to 0 to infinity alpha e to the power minus j omega to the power n. So that is a to the power n. So and it will be this GP series will converge, it will have a value 1 by 1 minus a. Okay, so a is nothing but here alpha e to the power minus j omega, right? And here condition is alpha should be less than 1. Okay, so this is the Fourier transform representation of this aperiodic signal, discrete time aperiodic signal alpha to the power n un. So this is very very important signal itself. So its Fourier transform is nothing but looks like this. So what is the magnitude spectrum? So if you look at the magnitude of this x of omega, so this will be nothing but, you can see this will be a periodic signal. Looks like this. Okay. So and the period is here from 0 to 2 pi. So this is omega. Sorry, this is omega. Okay. So this is the magnitude spectrum. And the spectrum, it's go like this. Okay. And it again repeats from here. You see, there is a repetition at every 2 pi. Okay. So this is the even function also, it go on like this. Now the phase spectrum of this would be nothing but, if you look at the phase spectrum, the phase spectrum again, it looks like this. Again, it is of periodic spectra, again of periodic of period nature 2 pi. Okay, so it is upon periodic of nature 2 pi. Right? Okay, so this is my phase spectra. Got the idea? So this is called a Fourier transform of discrete time aperiodic signal. Okay. Is there any doubt? You can ask me now. Otherwise, we'll wind up the class over here. Is it clear? Today we discussed Fourier series representation of continuous time signal, and then we come over to the Fourier transform, which is the Fourier representation of the non-periodic signal. Okay. So when it is non-periodic, then the frequency is continuous. And here for discrete time non-periodic signal, the spectra is continuous. You can see it is a continuous spectra, and it is periodic of 2 pi. Okay, 0 to 2 pi. It is periodic of nature 2 pi. Is it clear? If you have any doubt, you can ask me now. Thank you.